Hi there, and welcome back. Today, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about our restart and resume option. So you may find yourself at times dealing with an issue that needs one or even multiple computer restarts. It's for cases such as these where ISL Online's restart and resume option was designed. So as you see, I'm already in a session with a remote computer. Let's say I'm installing something or maintaining a computer in my database, or even troubleshooting one of my client's desktops. All I have to do is go up to the Tools button right here and select Administrative Mode, and then Reboot. In this case, the client already has administrative rights, so Administrative Mode is already enabled. If necessary, I can also restart the computer into Safe Mode, but this is not a situation that calls for it. So I'm just going to go with the former option, Reboot. Don't worry about that blue sign right there. That is merely there to reassure the remote side that ISL Lite has launched a reboot request. And now we wait for a bit. In the meantime, let me make one slight clarification. When it comes to unattended access, administrative mode is always enabled by default. So if we go to the dashboards and select computers, and connect to one of the computers, type the access password, and hit enter. Okay, so we are connected. Click the Tools button under Administrative Mode. We already have it enabled by default. This is because when you installed unattended access, you also entered the admin password. In other words, you needed admin rights to install ISL Always On. So that's why ISL Always On runs as a service under local system account, allowing admin mode, and therefore the restart and resume functionality, straight out of the box. However, if you're with a client with no administrative rights on the other side, your client will have to enable it here to get the ability to restart and to reconnect to the remote computer. Okay, so let's go back to the dashboard and under Session tab, click the Active Session. So as you can see, we restart the computer and we are back to the login screen. All right, so this was just a quick tip on how to restart and reconnect to a remote computer. For any questions, drop us a line at our live chat at islonline.com. Thanks for watching and see you next time.